Hi Dressed Cuties, Winnie here. Today we're going to draw Harry Potter's Snowy Owl Hedwig. So let's get started. To draw the Snowy Owl, let's start by drawing its eyes. So I'm going to come right here and draw a really big circle. And I'm going to come right to the other side and draw the same thing. So about this much. About right here, I'm going to draw another circle. So just leaving enough space for a beak right there. So let's come in here and make them draw so cute eyes. So I'm going to come in here with two small circles for highlights and a curved line at the bottom and shade in the top. Okay, and then lines at the bottom. And same thing over here. So if you love Harry Potter, please make sure to check out my Harry Potter playlist. And if you love owls, please also just Google Draw So Cute Owls. I've drawn a few over the years. And the lines at the bottom. Okay, huge eyes, right? Took forever. Okay, so then right here, about in this area, I'm going to draw a curve that kind of tapers into our eye. I just felt it was necessary to make it more owl-like for this eye. So you can give it a try if you like. So on this side, same thing. This side's easier for me to go this way. So just taper it into the eye there. Okay, so now to draw the beak. So a snowy owl's beak is pretty cool because it's surrounded by feathers. So I'm going to come right in the center right here and give myself a point. And I'm going to start to zigzag some indication of feathers. So let's come say about right here. I'm going to go up, down, up, and out. So I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm just going to follow and out. And then right in between, we can go ahead and draw the beak. So about right here, right in the center and up there. And I'm just going to come in here and shade it in black so you can see a little bit better. There. And then maybe I should have left a little highlight right here, right? We'll see. Maybe I'll change it when I color it. Okay, so now with this part right here, I'm going to zigzag some curves, so an indication of feathers and out. So same thing over here. So just indication. And then right here in the center, I'm going to come right in the center about right there. And I'm going to do the same thing at the top. So this one's going to be a little bit wider, stronger curves and zigzags. So same thing. So we're just framing our eyes. Okay, so now from there, let's come to the side of the eye. So I'm going to start, say, about right here. Give myself a little bit of space. But right there, I'm going to start to draw a curve around the eye. So same thing over here. Now we're going to start to draw the face. So I'm going to bring a curve pretty close down to the beak area. So it's going to come really close to here. So let's bring this curve. I'm going to work on this side. It's going to come around about right here. I'll start to bring it in. And in this area, I'm just going to draw some curves to give indication of feathers. If you're not comfortable doing that, you can just go ahead and draw a smooth curve. But let's see here, I'm just going to very lightly, and I'm going to come to the center about right here. So if you like, about right there. So same thing here. All right there, and then some curves, just very lightly, soft curves. There. Okay, so then now we can come to the center. We're going to draw the top of the head. So just imagine this kind of squarish head. So about right here, I'm going to come to the center. About right here, I'll give myself a point. And from this area, once again, the same thing. I'm going to draw some curves, soft curves at the top. And then as I come right here, I'm going to start to bring it down to connect. So same thing on this side. And about right here. To draw the body, we're going to come about right here, kind of where this eye is, about right here. I'm going to give myself a point. And on this side, about right here. So it's still pretty centered. This area, the 2 points, and I'm going to start by drawing, let's see here, I'm going to start with this side first. I'm going to draw a curve, and then this side's going to curve out for the wing. And right here, let's come in right under here, and we're going to draw a curve, comes out for our wing. So we're going to start to work on this wing, so let's come down. I'm going to draw a curve, first curve, bring it down another one, and just going to go slowly back and forth as we build this wing. So about right here, just going to go ahead and connect it back. There. And then let's come and draw this side right here. Now that we have that wing in, we can come in and bring the body. And I'm going to taper this curve all the way back into the wing, just to simplify it. And then on this side, we're just going to have some indication of the other side of the wing. So come right here, curve, and then just taper it in. There. And then let's come and draw the feet. So right in the center, we're going to start with the first one, give myself a point. And I'm going to draw a curve and another curve right there. So they have pretty strong feet. I'm going to come out and I'm just simplifying it. So I'm just going to draw 3 zigzags and connect back. So for the back one, just going in right here, come out once again and zigzag and taper in. And then now the tail. So I'm going to come out about right here, kind of following this angle for the tail feathers. 1, 2, maybe 3, and then just bring it in. Okay, and then so now let's draw some details. Some really cool patterns on a snowy owl that makes it a snowy owl. So right here in the wing area, I'm just going to draw these little crescents. And they're going to be dark. It's going to be black. So if you're using your pencil, just color it in when you're coloring. But since I have a Sharpie, it makes it easier to just go ahead and draw these patterns. So here and there, I'm just scattering some of these little crescents. There. Okay. And then right here on this part right here, the tummy area, you can just draw some soft curves or some feather texture. So there, hope you love my drastic cute snowy owl inspired by Hedwig from Harry Potter. Thanks so much for watching, and if you loved it, please make sure to subscribe so you won't miss any new drastic cute videos. See you later.